everyone, thanks for tuning in. You're watching Christian Adventure Gamer, your host Daniel the Paladin, finishing up the last two miniatures of the Scooby-Doo miniatures, right, from the Scooby-Doo board game. So, like, I have Scooby-Doo left, and I have the Creeper left. I wish there was a way I can buy the deluxe components, because I got the normal one for Christmas, and I don't even know if they make the deluxe one anymore, but, like, I'd really like to have those characters for this. But I want to show you what I've done so far. So I'll get the other camera ready. Let's zoom in. Alright, so we have Velma here. She's been washed, and she's been applied with a sealer, so she is good to go. Means you can handle her. She's not going to, the paint's not going to wear off as fast. We have Fred. Technically, he's still kind of drying from the sealer, but he's pretty good to go. There was some little bit overrun here. I'm not too worried about it. There you go. You can see his face. And we have the green ghost. I think the green wash turned out really good on him. And then here's the clown. Obviously, he's the first one I did. First one I completed. And again, I don't know if I've mentioned this. The mask that I painted on him is actually much bigger than the mask that he has on the card. Or even like the indentation, I guess. Like the markings on the miniature itself. I just thought a mask this size seemed more appropriate for the heinous crimes that he's trying to commit, right? We have Daphne here. I think that purple wash did really good on her. Helped in her hair. I put like an orange wash. I put the Gazandora yellow. I guess it looks orange, but it's yellow. On Daphne's face. Kind of help make that pop. And then Shaggy, I used that yellow wash on his head and face and arms. But everything else was green wash. I think it really helped him pop. Can help also blend in his chin hairs. Now it's a little heavy on here, on the green, but I'm okay with that. Maybe he just sat in something wet, you know? All right, let's zoom out. Alright, so I'm going to be painting these guys. So let's start with Scooby-Doo, because he's mostly brown, right? But we need a blue for his collar. And so I'm not sure if I want to use this. Try to use this. Or use this. Like, it's almost like an aquamarine blue one here. But I'm going to try a lighter blue first. Maybe not that light of a blue. Man. Is this any darker? That's still... That might be closer to what I'm looking for. So let's go ahead and... this one... Let's get the Scoob. So the inside of his tag is a blue. So I'm just going to fill it all in on the inside. And then I can just kind of brush over it to make gold. I think I'll just use a dark wash on him, maybe, to make like his mouth and stuff pop out. I think this is a good blue for his collar. Used to like watching Scooby-Doo and a pup named Scooby-Doo. Scooby-Doo and Scrappy 2. Alright, so his collar is now ready. And then we can get some brown. I got some various browns. I'm not sure which one I'm going to try. So I know like that chestnut brown I used earlier on the hair, it's just too dark. I need something a little brighter, something a little more orange kinda, I guess. So I brought this out. This is the tan skin. This is oiled leather. I thought about using oiled leather because this should pop really well when I put the wash on it. That might be the color I need, like an orangish color. And then I have a sandy brown. I'm not sure if that's too light. There's that chestnut brown again, so we'll try the oil leather. So that is... Let's see here. Can I pour it out? I don't know. Can I? Yeah, I see it coming. It's about dry in there, I think. I do have a new one. This is the oldest one. I just didn't want to mess with it. Lovely. Well, let's try that with Scooby-Doo. I'm gonna throw that bottle away when I'm all done. And so now I need a decent brush to kind of move a lot of paint around. I think I'll use this one. I'll just kind of cover all of them. Because his spots are pretty much distinguished in the miniature. So then I'll know exactly what to color black. I'll make sure just to cover everything, and then his base is pretty much lighter brown than he is, so I'm going to try to find one of these other colors, or use one of the other colors to color the top of the base, because that's what I've been obviously doing. When you notice the other miniatures, I've colored the bases on them. With the theme song to Pup Named Scooby-Doo in my head now. I just want to watch it now. Goodness gracious. Can't remember if I painted his eyes or not already. Yeah, this is a good color for him. Need to get a different brush real quick, the tip, to push paint into right where the collar meets the gold chain, I guess you would call it. Scooby-Doo, let's get your head. You'd have thought I would have got his eyes when I did everyone else's. I can't remember. They look white, so I think I did. Kind of inside of his ears as well. I'm going to use the flesh. Maybe I'll use the tan skin actually. Looks like his tongue is hanging out. So I gotta color that now. So I'm done with this brush because it doesn't really have a tip. The tip on it's actually kind of curled a little bit. So I'm gonna get the other brush out that I just used to help push that paint in between Scooby-Doo's eyes and around his eyes. So that way I don't have to worry about painting or touching up those eyes again in case I did paint them. So. Even Scooby-Doo's got eyebrows. As I touch up the eyes just to minuscule bit. It looks really good. I can definitely see where his pupils are. And I can see where his eyebrows are, so that'll be easy to paint. Now, the one thing about this leather paint is that it does shrink quite a bit usually. So I'm gonna make sure I go like over. There it is. Especially since I painted it really rather fast. I can't remember if he has any spots on his tail. I don't think he does. But... I gotta get a pink out. I just put the pink away. For his tongue. Yeah, I have a pink over here I could probably use. It's a turbo dork. It might be a little light, or color changing based on the light, but I think it'll be alright. Just a tongue. Let's see what I got here. I got Bubblegum Crisis. That'll work. Maybe. What's the other one I got? Peachy Keen. I don't think they're metallic. No, they are metallic. Okay. Never mind then. We have this here. It's a Vallejo Transparent Red. I'm pretty sure that's not going to be what I need. I have Lust Pink. It's an airbrush color, but... yeah, that would be way too thin. I can use that. It's a base. Bugman's Glow. Maybe. Eh. Probably better off just going and getting the pink back out. I know exactly where it's at. I'm not going to worry about it right now, though. So as we're waiting for Scooby to dry, we are going to paint this guy over here. He's kind of, like, I was watching a cartoon of it, because, like, again, these images aren't the best. And his outfit is a little more darker, actually. And so I'm seeing if I can find a darker green. Which here's a Viper green. I'm going to shake this up really good. It's almost like it needs like an olive green added to it, which I'm not sure what my olive green is. I have this too. Bertel's Rot. I guess we'll just try it. Let's use this that one again. His shoes are black in the cartoon. His shirt is black in the cartoon. His pants and overcoat is a green, like a dark green. He has got a lot of Flash on him. Flash is a like leftover plastic from the mold where the seam is. He's got a bunch of Flash on his foot and his leg right here. Which, you know, and I understand there may be, they make these things by probably hundreds of times. Hundreds at a time, you know, because they just keep popping them out and make sure that, you know, there's enough to fill orders. And then when molds start getting old, that's where they start producing extra Flash, right? Because they have to rip those things open, take the miniatures out, and wear and tear, whatever. But man, I wish I had a file, a little file. Yeah, it's a little too green, but I don't know what I have to do with it, because I don't know where my olive green is. I just went through all my paints. Maybe I used it up the last time I painted. Who comes up with the names with these creatures, right? Like, is it Hannah? Is it Barbara? Is it someone else? Like, the Creeper, really? They couldn't have named it something else. It basically looks like a Frankenstein. His skin is a paler green. So, a couple of options to see what, you know, how it might fare. He's going to need a couple coats. That is for sure. Not too worried about getting it on the inside where the shirt is, because that's going to be black anyway, so. A lot of area to cover on this guy. I think for him, since he's so green, when I go to put the wash on, I won't water it down. The way it sticks in the thicker areas, or, you know, produces thicker fluid for those areas. It can be kind of heavy. Like, there's a lot of creases in his arms and stuff that would allow those things to be really seen. Alright, let him dry. So I want to touch up his eye with some pure white. Scooby-Doo's eye, that is. And then I'm going to start using some black. It almost looks like Scooby-Doo is looking downwards, and I don't understand why he would. But, that's what I see. I'm going to touch up his collar. All right, now we need to do the black on him. First, I'm going to do his tongue. I wonder what this looks like. It's called elephid skin. And so, a lot of times these... Yeah, I think I'll use that for the tongue, actually. It's like a pinkish purple. It's like a dog's tongue would be, right? Looks good. All right. Now the black. His eyebrows. So I can do is keep people. I did it. Nice. Yeah. This person's eyes don't look like they're straight. So I'll move the pupil paint right a little more to the left, and I'll go back over with some white. Well, that's weird. It's like little dots on there symbolize his pupil. Now it's easy to paint. Alright, so let's go ahead and find a brush that I can use to paint his spots. Maybe that one. Let's see. To his nose, too. There we go. There's a spot right there. Back. Yeah, this brush is a little bit too bigger. Too big. What I'm trying to do. It's too long. But it might be perfect for getting into his shirt, though. That didn't sound very good. Let's get his shoes. Oh, and he gets mouth too. Oops. A little too much in his mouth, but I'll go back over. I need to switch brushes. This is not at all what I thought it would be. So, let's try this one. There we go. A lot more control. Big old clod hoppers. I'm gonna touch up pants a little bit because I got some black on it. All right. All right, so let's go back to Scooby-Doo. See if this will produce more control using this brush. Smaller, but... move his tail out of the way, just a hair. I don't want to get paint on it. I look at some pictures of his tail because I got to figure out if there are spots on it or not. I can't remember. I don't think there are, but there could be, right? So I got those. Two spots there. There's a spot on his knee, I see. Oops. Not sure how big it is, that's the question. There's a spot there. Spot here. Alright, now let's see. Picture of Scooby-Doo. I don't think there was one on his back knee, but who knows. Nope, there wasn't. Just the two on each side, one on his back and his nose. Interesting. So what it looks like in the model, it looks like there's a spot there, but I'll cover that back up. All right. Alright. Go back to covering up his mouth again. Alright. This color. Looks like he's already got dimples on his face for his whiskers some, so I might not try to dry brush because the melon oil I use will fill that in. This is not a good brush for these bigger areas. I want to set that there. There we go. The spot on the knee because it's not supposed to be there. This color usually shrinks quite a bit, so. It's not surprising that I have to touch up or go back over certain areas. But it usually looks really good when you add some oil to it. Like Nolan oil, that is. Scooby is about done. the gold out. Now let's look at this guy over here. Let's use this and see if it gives me the skin color I'm looking for. I'm looking for like a pale green. No, that's more of a bright green. Looking for almost like a sickening green, like someone's sick to their stomach. That's even brighter. I wonder if I can add some white to it. Add some off-white. I'll throw this little bright green in there just to, yeah, there we go. There we go. All right, so let's use this brush then to paint his skin. I'll start with his hands. In his face, I'm going to have to use a different brush. Yep, that's the color I'm looking for. It's time for a new set of brushes. His hand is just way too close to his shoe. Why? Why would you do that? Alright. There we go. Kind of looks like a creep, doesn't he? Looks like his face is all ready. He's gonna put some more coats on his jacket. Viper green, eh? Just use this one. This one's new. Yeah, it's new enough to be clogged. It's not what I meant to do, but it is what happens. If you guys have a brush to go in between, like the part of his shirt that's exposed, and right inside his cuffs. I don't want to mess that up. Let that dry, because I'm going to have to put on a third coat. Let's go back to Scooby-Doo and see if we can't touch up the black. Touch up his eyes. And we're going to use some more white. His eye is fixed. So I need to touch up. Some brown. We can try to do the gold. Where did I do it? There it is. This is going to be a little more difficult to paint. Let's see if I can even pour it out. Nope, I have to take the cap off. Don't need a whole lot, just a small area. Alright, so let's see here. Kind of like paint dries super fast, so. That's good enough. Touch up the brown around it. I can see blue behind it, which is good. I gotta do gold on the other side of it. Of the part, the chain or whatever that goes over the collar. There we go. let's try to get that black in there. The eyebrows. Touch up his nozzle. Yes. That'll do. Touch up his spot. Scooby, you're about done. All right. So let's get inside his ear. So let's put this in there. It's like a tan skin. Hopefully I can squeeze it out. There we go. Not too much. Getting that caught before I stuck that in there. Got his ear twisted a little bit. I don't know why. I think this will be twisted to the outside, but it's not really. But because it's supposed to be, I will paint the what's supposed to be the inside of his ear. Touch up the brown. I can use a little bit bigger of a brush because I have more area to work with. So I will use this one. It's a tan leather, really not brown. Alright, Scoob. I think you're good enough to be done. Alright, Scooby-Doo is done other than his base, which I should do a orange or brown, so I wonder if I just add a little orange over here. I'll take some of that. Mix it and see if that produces a brown or orange. So that's a big old clumpy stuff here. Maybe a little more orange. That's a lot of paint on there. I don't want to do that. Now let's try it. It's definitely an oranger tint to it. His base is done. I need to touch up right next to this little tag. And I don't want this to get messed up. Side. Alright, set Scooby aside so he can dry so I can wash him. And then this guy, I need to do another coat, I need to do his eyes. So I'll get the off-white. And I can do his pupil as well. I don't think I have to touch up his hair any. Maybe just a hair. Which is chestnut, so I still have it here. But before I do anything else like that, I want to put on another coat. He's about done too. So I got some brawn. Alright, now I can switch brushes to get inside where his coat, overcoat, and shirt meet, and obviously in his cuffs. Tight spot. Out that brush. Let's do his pupil. Pupils. Alright, so he's got one right here. He's squinting with the other one. It's good enough. Touch of his face, skin color. And then a little bit of hair. Alright. I'm gonna paint his base real quick. Let's actually use this one. I can push it easier. All right, I think he's done. All right, awesome. All right, so I have the creeper done and Scooby-Doo done. The only thing I need to do is wash them and then put the final touch on them, which is the sealer, right? Put the sealer on them. And then obviously put black rings around the base themselves. So don't go anywhere because I'm going to do that. And then I'm going to show again every miniature I painted if it's going to be a board game. All right. Give me a second. Be right back. And I am back. So I finally have everything's done, completed. I got the Scooby-Doo, the creep, Ghost Clown, Fred, Velma, Daphne, Shaggy, not Scooby, Shaggy, and the Green Ghost. So let's go ahead and take a look at them on the other camera. And so let's go ahead and just zoom in. So here is the Green Ghost. I used green wash on him because he's green, obviously. But then here I used Nolan oil on the chain because that would make it pop better. And then I have the Daphne. She was actually a lot easier to paint than I thought she would be. All right. Then we have Shaggy. And I noticed this, that their eyes are actually pointed in the same direction as the cards. That's why there's pupils, and why they look like they're looking down. So they're Shaggy. Oops. My ghost clown falls over too easy. We have Fred. I used a blue wash on him, most of his body except for his head and face, where I used the yellow shade. We got the ghost clown, obviously. I've showed this one a couple times. And you can head over on to my Facebook page and comment on which one you like the most. Because I've been taking pictures as I've been going through them and posting them on the Facebook page for Christian Adventure Gamer. And then here is the Velma. I think I nailed the glasses, the color of the glasses. Very proud of that. And the red shoes. Let's move these back, because these are still technically drying. So here is the Creep. I used all the, like, I just only used the green wash on this, I'm trying to say. Only used the green wash. So if I go over here, you can see his face a little bit better. He's kind of squinting with the other eye. He was actually pretty difficult to paint because the green took three coats. Probably could have used another one, but it is what it is. And here's my favorite one. Is the Scoopster, right? And I think he did a pretty good job on him. Yeah. Alright, so also, like, I used some things for the first time today. I used this thing, which is actually sitting right here, you can see it. I got this for Father's Day, but I believe my wife got it on Amazon. It actually worked a lot better than I thought it would. Like, the review said that they leak and stuff, and you can't leave it sit for too long. But I have not seen the water raise more than what it should when I flush it. Basically, you push this button down, and it flushes, right? Creates a vacuum, right, and the water moves. It works pretty good. I like it. And then I'm using the red grass wet palette for the very first time. So it came with 15 membranes, which they were all reusable. So I've actually reused this one three times. Take it out, wash it. Then underneath it is the pad, and it came with two pads. So I think those will last a really long time. It did leave the paint open for a lot longer. It's like right now the black is still open, this off-white is still open, I can tell that this white is still open, so yeah, I think it works really, really well. I'm happy I got it. And then I had this new base here, right, so it's magnetic, it just sits on it. This was by Cobalt Keep, I think. It's okay. I mean, magnet works pretty good. But obviously, if you move it too much, so like it's meant to be held like this, and you can paint it and stuff. But it has several attaches. It actually has an attachment with a magnifying glass, and an attachment with a light. So, oops, and it also came with little pliers. I'm not sure why, but this, I think, goes here on the side. And then it comes with a charger, so you can charge your light. Oh, it's come with a charger in. And then the magnifying glass here. Well, maybe this goes on the side. I think they're interchangeable where you put them. But wherever. But then, obviously, then you attach it, and then you can see what you're painting. Then with the light, that's going to help a lot. See, that's the one thing I don't like. If you move your hand up too much, it will fall off. Oof, there's like three levels of lights. But yep. Scoop. All right. So hopefully you like this video. I know that some of them are kind of long. I think what I might try to do in the future is like skip over certain parts of my painting. Or maybe cram it together so it moves real fast. But the only problem is that when I talk, I have to like edit that so it's normal length, and it's kind of weird. It's just a lot of editing. If I had some background music that didn't throw any alerts on YouTube, I definitely could do that. But anyways, I'm excited to play Scooby-Doo, the board game. Hopefully you enjoyed following me as I paint these miniatures. My kids have been away for the weekend visiting Grandma and Grandpa, and so give me a chance to do this, and I think that they're going to be excited to play with painted miniatures. All right, hey, thanks for tuning in. See you guys next time.